Hey all, it's Matt, your average gamer. This is a highly requested video on my top 10 Ash of War builds. Instead of going for pure damage and a lot of buffs, I rank these Ash builds in Elden Ring based on how convenient they are to use and basically how good they are in battle. This will go into detail on ranking the most powerful Ash of War builds and then factor in how easy they are to use in combination with their damage output. Because we're keeping this convenient, we'll only be using 2 buffs for each build, not counting the tier. This will keep the build simpler, but also give them solid damage. Before we continue though, if you like G Fuel, be sure to check out the description for 20% off with the code YOURAVERAGEGAMER in all capital letters. You can support the channel out as well through the links. Number 10 on this list is Spinning Slash, a powerful Ash of War that could do a lot of successive attack damage and bleed with the right weapons. Here I've chosen the Nagakiba, which is awesome for damage and fits well on a Colt with Spinning Slash. This is a powerful up-and-close option that, while sometimes being a little hard to pull off in terms of all of the Ash of War, does great damage and is often reliable as well. This is a solid one, and at number 10 we have Spinning Slash. Here's our equipment. Now this is the same setup as Double Slash, which we'll show later in the video, but we have Spinning Slash on the Nagakiba, the White Mask, Dragon Communion Seal, Shard of Alexander, Lord of Blood's Exaltation, Rotten Wing Sword Insignia, Melissa's Prosthesis, Faith Tier for buffs, Thorny Tier. Let's get into stats. By the way, we're using Golden Vow and Flame Grant Me Strength. As you can see here, we have 60 Arcane, and then we have 18 Strength, and we have a little bit of extra Dexterity with Melissa's Prosthesis for a well-rounded Spinning Slash build. At number 9, we have Earthshaker, an Ash that is growing on me the more I use it. This Ash award does solid poise damage and can crush some of the main and side bosses with its initial slam down and follow-up attack. The follow-up swing can be done with R2 or RT and does a lot of damage, so be sure to follow up the main Ash when you can for additional damage. This is one that's great on a strength or fire build. The only downside here is that the entire animation is somewhat on the slow side. It is a little bit slower to use, but as you can see the poise damage here, it goes well with the stance breaking tier. You get a lot of damage as a whole. You can throw in some charge attacks too, but that initial slam down, the follow-up attack, Earthshaker is a solid, powerful Ash of War. Let's get new equipment for this build and setup on Earthshaker. And for this setup, we have the Heavy Guts Greatsword with Earthshaker on it. Any seal will do here. We have a random set of armor on. We have the Ritual Shield Talisman, Shard of Alexander, Ritual Swords Talisman. We have the Erdtree's Favorite +2, Faith Tier, and the Stance Breaking Tier. The stats are on the right. I'll show the strength stats later in the video. Because I wanted to save a little bit of time with that, we're going to be showcasing Lion's Claw and a few other ones that are strength related. At number 8, we have Black Flame Tornado. I wanted to put this Ash of War higher, but as you'll see here, I get beat up a fair bit from the Magma Worm. The issue with Black Flame Tornado is simple. It has virtually no hyper armor at all. You can easily be knocked out of it even with 51 or 101 poise, the poise thresholds. It's almost as if the Ash itself reduces the hyper armor you have instead of adding to it. You'll often get knocked out of the animation using it, however its damage cannot be ignored. It goes well with a Flame Art weapon to fit the Fate Scaling the Ash has, and is one of the highest damage Ashes of War to build around in Elden Ring. This is one that is awesome to pull off too. If I were talking sheer damage, this Ash of War would be top 5 for sure. But since we're going for convenience here, I'm content putting it at number 8 due to the lack of hyper armor it has. Maybe a future patch will eventually give us some of the hyper armor that is needed with this Ash of War because it's super cool to use. It's really fun to use. It does a lot of percentage and fire damage, but again, you can so easily be knocked out of this Ash of War that it's not going to make it in my top 5 given the lack of hyper armor. And yeah, it really is one of those overpowered Ashes of War for sure in terms of how much damage it does. It checks that box. It also checks the fun box too. So if you're looking for a fun and overpowered build, this is definitely one of those ones that can easily fit that description. That being said, I do have some issues with the hyper armor. Let's get into equipment for this build. For equipment, we have the Grave Scythe in Flame Art with Black Flame Tornado. The Erdtree Seal would go well with this, but any weightless seal is nice. We have the Shard of Alexander, Fire Scorpion Charm, Ritual Swords Talisman, Dragon Crest Great Shield Talisman. We have the Fire Tier, Faith Tier. I'm going to show the stats for this one on the next one, which is Flaming Strike. And at number 7, as mentioned, we have one of my favorite Ashes of War to build around in Elden Ring, Flaming Strike. Flaming Strike is awesome. It's not so much the Ash itself for me, but rather using it on the Bandit Curved Swords and then using jump attacks in combination with the Ash when needed to do immense fire damage. The only downside is, it's basically a fire version of a bleed build if you're going for damage. The Ash itself is also 2 inputs, and it takes a few extra seconds to put both swords on fire. Let's get new equipment here. For equipment, we have two Bandit Curved Swords in Flame Art with Flaming Strike on that, a random set of armor on with the Raptor's Black Feather, Shard of Alexander, Fire Scorpion Charm, Rottenwing Sword Insignia. We have the Claw Talisman, Fire Tier, Thorny Tier. Let's get into stats for this one and the last build. As you can see here, we're using Golden Vow and Flame Grant Me Strength for this build, and we have 70 Faith, so we really pumped a lot of points into our Faith stat to get a lot of damage out of Flame Art weapons and Black Flame Tornado and Flaming Strike for well-rounded Faith-based builds. In number 6, we have Double Slash, which is super powerful and goes well with a Katana. I put the Nagakiba on a Colt here, but once again, you could do this in Keen Affinity with Blood Flame Blade. And if you go for Keen Affinity with Blood Flame Blade, you end up having the extra buff, and it does good damage overall, but you do end up with split damage and a little bit of fire damage. By the way, the animation of Double Slash is on the longer side and ends with a powerful slam down. The lengthy animation can be difficult to land all of it sometimes, making it powerful, but certainly not the safest Ash of War to use in Elden Ring. And in a second, we're going to go over a Double Slash build for an Occult Nagakiba. You can put this on the starting Katana too and get really good scaling and a lot of damage that way. Also, we're going to go over equipment in a second. And this is a pretty awesome build overall, but it's definitely an up and close and personal build. Let's get into equipment. For equipment, we have the Occult Nagakiba with Double Slash. We have the Dragon Communion Seal. We have the White Mask. You don't really need the Raptor's Black Feathers for this build. Shard of Alexander, Lord of Blood's Exaltation, Rottenwing Sword Insignia, Listen's Prosthesis, Faith Tier, Thorny Tier. Let's get into stats. For stats, it's the same setup as Spinning Slash. We're using Golden Vow and Flame Grant Me Strength. We have 60 Arcane, 25 Faith with the Faith Tier so we can do our buffs, 27 Dex, 60 Vigor for a well-rounded Double Slash build. At number 5, we have Wild Strikes. Now, Wild Strikes on any other weapon, I feel like it's good, but on the Rusted Anchor, it's epic. It does a ton of pure damage from a strength build and can build on successive attacks fast for a heavy weapon. The only downside here is that it has a bit of a long wind-up time and can be difficult to keep it going sometimes. Overall, I enjoy this Ash of War, and you can also grab this one very early in Elden Ring. It can be grabbed in Limgrave. It's an awesome Ash of War overall, and it fits really well with the Rusted Anchor. Let's get new equipment. For equipment, we have the Rusted Anchor and Heavy Affinity with Wild Strikes. Any seal will do here. We have a random set of armor on, Rottenwing Sword Insignia, Shard of Alexander, Melissa's Prosthesis, Urtree's Favorite Plus 2. We have the Faith Tier and Thorny Tier. We'll show the stats later on when we go over Lion's Claw. At number 4, we have Royal Knight's Resolve, which makes it into the top 4, but not the top 3. This is a great Ash of War with a lot of power. It boosts your next regular hit by 80%, which can be utilized to destroy bosses fairly easily. As I mentioned early, we're only going to be using two buffs, Golden Vow and then Hallish Bravery or Flame Grip Me Strength to keep things simpler to understand. Here, we're still able to get several thousand damage per charge hit on the Giant Crusher. There are many great weapons to use Royal Knight's Resolve with, and the bigger the weapon, the more damage you'll likely hit for. I would put Carrion Grandeur around the same rank as Royal Knight's Resolve, also being a nuke option for magic builds as opposed to strength investment. They're great on their own, but with using only two buffs and keeping things simple, there's three better options I have for you. The top three on here I think are a lot easier to use and understand, where you don't have to go too crazy with buffs for them, right? They're going to be simple and they're going to be really powerful. The top three on here are three that I like a lot. I do like Royal Knight's Resolve, don't get me wrong, but typically when I'm using this Ash of War, I'm using a lot of buffs with it as well. Now we're going to continue to keep things simple and we're going to get new equipment for this build and setup. For equipment, we have the Giant Crusher with Royal Knight's Resolve and Heavy Affinity. We had the Golden Vow Ash of War, random set of armor on, Axe Talisman, Ritual Swords Talisman. We have the Fire Scorpion Charm, Urtree's Favorite Plus 2, and then we have the Fire Tier, and then the Charge Tier as well. At number 3, we have Seppuku, an incredibly powerful Ash of War. This will add a lot of bleed to your blood or occult-based weapon and can do a ton of damage. Seppuku for me, though, is not the number 1 due to both bleed-resistant bosses as well as the animation it takes to start a battle. Maybe it's just me, but having to stab my character once each before I go into a fight can sometimes feel a bit lengthy. Now we're going to go into equipment for this build and setup. We have two Scavenger Curved Swords on Occult with Seppuku. We have the Dragon Communion Seal, White Mask, Raptor's Black Feathers, Claw Talisman, Lord of Blood's Exaltation, Rottenwing Sword Insignia, Melissa's Prosthesis. We have the Faith Tier and then the Thorny Tier as well. In number 2, we have a really easy one to use, Lion's Claw. This Ash can be grabbed almost from the start of the game in Kaelid, and is so easy and simple to use, I can only think of one on here that's easier. The main downside is it leaves you vulnerable while you're in the air, but it does amazing damage and its payoff is fantastic. Giant Hunt in many ways is similar too, although I still find myself having more fun with Lion's Claw. This is certainly one that can carry you late game as well, as you can go to Heavy Affinity or Fire Affinity to get a lot of damage out of it. This is no doubt an awesome Ash of War. You can grab this one early. It's incredibly powerful. It can pretty much carry you through the entire game. It does a lot of poise damage too. Yeah, anyone that's used Lion's Claw can pretty much tell you it's incredibly reliable. It's a very powerful Ash of War, and if you put it on Guts Greatsword, you have a lot of range right with it too. So you're going to be able to use this Ash, and then Guts will basically allow you to leap pretty far and have that extra range with a powerful weapon, heavier fire affinity. You're going to get a lot of damage out of this one. And no doubt, Lion's Claw has carried a lot of players and is still carrying a lot of players. It's that good. And I know we picked a complete random assortment of bosses, but this mixes in with a video I'm doing my top 8 overpowered for tomorrow. For the equipment, we have the Fire Guts Greatsword with Lion's Claw. You can do Heavy Affinity as well, random set of armor on, Fire Scorpion Charm, Shard of Alexander, Ritual Swords Talisman, Urtree's Favorite Plus 2, Faith tier, and then we have the Stance Breaking tier. Let's get into stats for this one. Now for stats here, we have 70 strength, and this is good for pretty much all the strength-based builds I did in this video. We're using Golden Vow and Flame Grant Me Strength, and we have 60 Vigor for a well-rounded strength build. I wanted to show this clip to show off Lion's Claw once more because I wanted to highlight this with the number one. The number one that I have on this list is one I've been using a lot lately, but I wanted to show real quick how good Lion's Claw truly is, and then some of the tougher regular enemies in the game, like the bear here, who can, I think, bother a lot of players. You can get good poise damage and do a lot of damage to them. Around 35-ish posture damage with Guts Greatsword and Lion's Claw, so it's a fairly good bit. You will get that poise-breaking opportunity with this Ash of War. It's solid. And number one, the most convenient Ash of War I've used lately is without a doubt Ice Spear. This Ash is incredible, not just for damage, but for how truly easy it is to use too. From the range frost and magic damage to how spammable it is, it truly is one of the best Ashes in Elden Ring to build around. I've been using this Ash of War more and more lately, and I find it better every time I use it. I'm really enjoying Ice Spear, not just for how easy it is to use, but for the damage too. The combination makes it fantastic. Interestingly, we have two Ice Spear builds for you here. This Ash scales with both Dexterity and Magic, as well as the base damage on the weapon. Here we show off Cold versus Keen on a Dexterity build. And later in a little bit on the second build, we're going to go over a couple different things with the Magic Affinity and show off the Clayman's Harpoon. But here, we're using the Guardian Sword Spear. We're going to talk about how the base damage affects that, and how good the base damage is on the Guardian Sword Spear. Makes it an awesome weapon for Ice Spear. You're going to see, for regular enemies, they're so easy with this Ash. You can spam it and destroy them with ease. They pretty much vanish with this overpowered Ash of War. This is one crowd control, even on New Game Plus 7, which all of this footage was, by the way, is fairly easy. This is really powerful for crowd control and for mobs. Golden Shade were able to do great damage despite his immunity to frost. The magic damage, which is Golden Vow and Hallish Fury, is excellent, and the return for the FP you're using is great too. You're going to see me take on Morgott as well with this amazing Ash of War, and the two builds I have are amazing for both damage and ease of use. Golden Shade would go down quickly, as will both bosses with one of the most basic and spammable Ashes in all of Elden Ring. If you're factoring both damage and ease of use, Ice Spear is absolutely a winner. Now, Golden Shade doesn't have a lot of HP. We're going to take on Morgott as well. We're going to show an NPC type enemy up here in a second too, and just continue to show off the power of Ice Spear on two different builds. The NPC up here is easy to destroy, as are most. Keep in mind though, some bosses and enemies can dodge Ice Spear. Melania would be able to dodge it, but they will also sometimes dodge into it as well. This is a very easy one to use and understand that has a very good damage amount for the amount of FP you're using. Can't stress that enough. The damage to FP ratio, on top of being able to just constantly spam it, is amazing. For Morgott on our Ice Spear Dexterity build, we're able to get great damage while also keeping reasonable distance. This allows frost build up from a mid-range while dishing out pure magic damage. This is also boosted by the Spellblade set, giving it up to 8% more damage in total too. Morgott would vanish quicker than expected, and if you want to see Ice Spear on a late game boss, my updated list of my top 8 overpowered builds in Elden Ring is going to be out tomorrow, and that will have Ice Spear on it with Beast Clergyman and Malika. It's a great fight and shows off how truly powerful and simple Ice Spear is. It can actually make the game easier by using this Ash of War. I really do believe it is easy with this Ash of War. Let's talk about our dexterity build. Here we have the Guardian Sword Spear in keen affinity with Ice Spear on it. Any seal will do. Spellblade set and the Bull Goat chest piece. Shard of Alexander, Magic Scorpion Charm, Ritual Swords Talisman, Dragon Crest Great Shield Talisman, Magic Tier, Faith Tier. Let's get into stats. First stats, we have 60 dexterity. We got to 33 faith, so we can do some buffs as well with Golden Vow and Hallish Shabriri. We have 60 vigor, 21 mind, 27 durance. Overall, this is a well-rounded build. It takes advantage of how powerful the Guardian Sword Spear is in keen affinity and how powerful Ice Spear is. For build 2 here, we've gone for 50 intelligence and 20 dexterity, and have gone for magic affinity on the Clayman's Harpoon versus the Guardian Sword Spear. The Sword Spear's ridiculous base damage factors in and gives us over 100 more damage in total. The Guardian Sword Spear is likely the perfect weapon to fit an Ice Spear build, given its scaling that factors in, as well as the base damage on the weapon. It's an awesome combination that can give you a ton of damage, and when you put it in magic affinity, you can get awesome damage too, while you run an intelligence build. Yeah, it truly is awesome. Throw it in magic affinity, you can get a lot of damage. It's pretty split between dexterity and intelligence scaling, and I know it's weird it scales with dex, but trust me, I tested on both. It does scale with dexterity too, but it also scales with magic. Those are the two main factors for Ice Spear and the base damage on the weapon. Here we add one more buff in Terra Magica because we're a mage now. This allows us to do insane damage that's similar to Night Comet. Hitting the tree sentinels here for almost 4,000 damage per quick Ice Spear is insane and certainly makes for an easy build that can take down a lot of bosses in Elden Ring with ease. This is my favorite Ash of War to use now to breeze through stuff, and I can't believe it took me over a year to realize how truly good Ice Spear is by testing it with many different weapons and affinities. Keep in mind, Ice Spear drops from one of the Knight's Cavalry bosses in Liurnia of the Lakes. Very easy to nab this early too and start building around. By the way, if you're wondering how I sound, I finally had the apioectomy after 3 months of having an infected tooth. Hopefully it's out now. I'm really hoping so. It was done on Monday and my tooth, that area is still swollen and everything. As far as equipment, we have the Guardian Sword Spear in magic affinity. Any staff will do using Terra Magica. Same armor on. Shard of Alexander, Magic Scorpion Charm, Ritual Swords Talisman, Dragon Crest Great Shield Talisman, Magic Tier, Faith Tier. Let's get into stats. For buffs, we're using Golden Vow, Hallish Shabriri, and Terra Magica if you want. We have 60 Vigor, 50 Intelligence, and we threw in a little Dexterity because it does have Dexterity scaling at 20. We hit 33 Faith, obviously, for the buffs. This ended up being another well-rounded setup. If you want to run this as a mage, you can lean more towards this setup. If you want to run it on Keen Affinity, Guardian Sword Spear, go for the Dexterity build for a lot of damage. I hope everyone enjoyed my top 10 apical Ashes of War in Elden Ring, many of which can be turned into powerful builds. My updated list of my top 8 overpowered and fun builds will be up tomorrow. That should be a good video as well that extends greatly upon this one and adds some more fun in there too. Thanks for watching this one and hope you all have a wonderful day, and be sure to subscribe for more Elden Ring content.